Oh, the Rose Mosque. Hiya, Theodosia. Huh, okay. So, ghoul means rose, okay. Huh. Oh, and when they say we're taken prisoner, that's a nice way to put it, Ubisoft. Most likely, the men were sold into slavery and the women were raped and sold into slavery. So, yeah. It's a nice way to put it, taken as prisoners. Yeah. Very PC of you. Hence is why I flick off that disclaimer at the start of every Assassin's Creed game. So that's just kind of a tragic mosque, I guess. Well, I mean, Hagia Sophia. I mean, that was even worse over there. What happened over there after the fall of Constantinople. But to be fair, whenever the Christians conquered a Muslim city, they pretty much did the same thing. Kill all the men, rape the women, and enslave the survivors. Brutal times, man, brutal times, but hey, that shit still goes on. I mean, ISIS was doing some crazy fucking shit for a couple of years there. Yep. I guess the point isn't to judge, the point is to be better, I guess. Yeah. Because, I mean, you can't judge the people who lived in this time. I mean, my God. How different their, you know, growing up, how different their childhood would have been from yours is pretty astounding. Ah, nymphs. They're kind of kinky. I think in the God of War games, I actually got to have sex with a nymph. That was fun. Need the sun to come back up. It's gonna be kind of hard to take this place in.
What is your problem?
My boot to your head, that's my problem. Huh. So the Vatican took over. Okay. Huh. That's interesting. Christians were still allowed to worship there. Huh. Kinda rare. I mean, the Ottomans were pretty rough when they took the city, but I mean, they were actually a pretty good thing for this city. They definitely breathed a lot of new life into it. Oh wow. Which mosque is that? That's pretty. Ah. Bayezid's Mosque. Should have known. Bayezid-i, some, yeah. Yeah. Earthquakes. Yeah, that's kind of the one problem of the area that they built the city in. It's right near the fault lines. Oh wow, yeah, this is a nice mosque. Yeah, it kind of does look like the Fatim Mosque. I don't even know if I'm pronouncing that. Yeah, I don't even know if I'm pronouncing that word right. Probably not. It's probably like Fatah or Fatih Mosque or whatever. The word Fatih, Fatah, blah, blah, blah. God only knows. I wouldn't mind learning Turkish. It's a pretty interesting language. Especially their writing system, because after the collapse of the Byzantine Empire, they actually switched from Arabic script to Latin script. So it's kind of interesting. Reading a Arabic-esque language in Latin. Yeah. It's kind of interesting. And naturally, I mean, the language isn't totally different from Greek. I mean, these two cultures definitely have had a few run-ins in the past, dating all the way back to the Trojan War, so, yeah. Alright, I think the Grand Bazaar will be it. Yeah. Kind of a lackluster place to end on, but, eh. Gotta go shopping somewhere, man. Yeah, I think Ezio's knees would be very happy with me right now. Holy shit. Now there's a super mall. Holy crap. 3,000 shops, 20,000 people work there. Wow. No telling what kind of stuff you would find here, man. Wow. Definitely gotta check this out when I come to Istanbul. Wonder if they, I'm sure they got artifacts for sale, antiques. Probably mostly fake, but still. Wow. Yeah, imagine what this place smells like. Yeah, and definitely, mental note, come to the Grand Bazaar when you come to Istanbul. Yeah. That's pretty cool. Get some rugs, get some cool clothes, get some artifacts or some antiques. Yeah, man.